Here we have already created an Angular project named Tutorial. In case you don't know how to create an Angular project, you can refer my previous video in which I have taught how to create one. We will be using VS Code as our code editor as it works very smoothly with Angular applications. This is how a newly created Angular application's HTML page looks like. We will now start the application using the command ng serve open. To show the circular progress chart, we will be using ng circle progress library, as it is a simple circle progress component created for Angular based only on SVG graphics and has various options to customize it. This is how a new application looks like. Just type ng circle progress on Google and click on the first link that appears. It will be from npm.js. npm.js is like a repository which demonstrates many cool libraries. I have provided the link for the same in the description. Now we will need to install the library in our Angular project. For that, just go to the terminal and paste the command. Meanwhile the library gets installed, we can see that there are different types of circular progress graphs. We will be creating the fifth graph in this tutorial, as I personally feel it very decent and cool at the same time. We need to import the ng circle progress module in our Angular project to be able to use it. So just copy this line of code and paste it in your app module file. Then we need to copy this piece of code and paste it in the imports array of the module file. We are now done with all the installation and importing process. Next, we need to change the code in the HTML file. I have already written a piece of code for the HTML file. The same code has been given in the description. Just copy the same code and paste it in your HTML file. I am just closing the second instance of the terminal as its job is done. After pasting the code, refresh your browser to view the changes. The library comes with a lot of properties which we can change according to our convenience. I will be changing and demonstrating some properties in the following video, starting with the title property. You can also change the properties like title color, font size, and font weight. Clockwise property can be used to change the direction of the animation. Animation duration property is used to change the speed of the animation. The property can also be modified from the HTML file. The value of the property in the HTML file overrides the one in the module file. You can also display the subtitle below the title. Same as title, you have options to change subtitle font size, its weight and color. show units can be toggled to show percentage symbol beside the title. There are two strokes in this graph. We can change the color and the width for both the strokes. We can change all the properties dynamically as well. We need to create variables in the TS file and use them in the HTML file.